Hi there. Today I'd like to talk about what to pack and how to pack for our Everest Base Camp trek. When hiking through the Himalayas, you need to be prepared for all types of weather. Trekking to high altitude requires you to bring all those different types of layers. You need lightweight, you need heavyweight, and you need to be able to put those on and off throughout the day so that you keep your temperature, your core body temperature regulated so that you're not sweating, but you're not freezing. Underwear is your first layer. It is something that needs to be comfortable. You want it to stay in place. You don't want it to bunch up. So try on a bunch of different options and find something that really suits you. Women, you definitely want a great sports bra. Something that, again, is comfortable where the straps aren't digging in and it's comfortable with your backpack on. Something that's going to give you the right support. So again, get out there, try them on, test them out, and find what's best for you. Next, we're going to talk about socks. Happy feet start with sock liners. Sock liners are great because they reduce the friction between your heel and the boot. Next, we have a lightweight sock. These are great for the lower elevations when it is quite warm and you don't need a thick, hot sock. Then we have our midweight socks. These actually are my favorite socks that I bring. They are made by Darn Tough and they don't smell, so you can wear these guys more than once. Now, as we get higher up in the elevation, temperatures are gonna drop and your little toesies are gonna get quite cold. So the next option is your really thick weight warm socks. These are also great to sleep in, so bring multiple pairs of these. Here we have our base layer. It's the first layer that I always put on, and I always choose a short sleeve. You never know what the weather's gonna do, so it's always great to have that short sleeve on first so that you can take off your other layers and drop down to just a short sleeve shirt. When it gets cold out, you may want your base layer bottoms. Again, these are great if they're in a polypropylene material or a merino wool. Now, the merino wool is great because it is an anti-stink material, so you and your fellow campers and trekkers are going to be happy if you've got these ones on. Next, I have a long sleeve merino wool base layer. Again, these are great to go on after your t-shirt so that as it warms up, you're able to take this off, have the t-shirt on underneath, and still stay warm if you need. Next is your mid layer. Now for a mid layer, I like the kind that have the 3/4 zip. You're able to open it up if it gets a bit warm. And again, this can be worn with just a t-shirt underneath. If it's cold, you can also have the long sleeve base layer and then your mid-weight base layer. Here we have my hiking pants. These are great because they're non-cotton. They also are a little bit water resistant. These are great if you get caught in the rain. Before you have time to put those pants on, you have a little bit of resistance in these. Now you may be wondering why I wear black pants. Black is a great color because it absorbs the heat, so it keeps you warmer when it's cold. It hides all of the dirt, so you can wear these more than once. And what I love about these pants are that they don't have a zipper or a button, so it's quite easy to get them on and off when you need to use the restroom. One of my favorite layers is actually my down vest. Most people forget about this down vest as a layer, but it's great because it keeps your core warm, but your arms are still able to breathe a little bit more. This is definitely one of the things I always bring on any of my trips that I go on. Next, I have my down sweater. Now, this little guy stays with me everywhere I go. It's in my backpack during the day. I have it out on my breaks when the wind picks up and you get chilly. It's great to just pull that out of your backpack and put this little layer on. It's also really nice because it packs down to almost nothing. It's super lightweight, so you're not carrying a lot of extra weight. And again, it is a little bit water resistant. Now, when it gets really cold, I bring out the big dog. And that's my really, really thick down parka. Now, I really enjoy this one. Ladies, you may also like the Rab. It is a little bit more cut for a feminine look, so you're not looking like a big marshmallow walking around. This thing keeps you warm. It retains all of the heat inside. It has zippers that are fully sealed, so water's not going to get in there. What also is great about this jacket is that it comes with a little stuff sack. So again, you can stuff this big old jacket into this little bag and keep that in your backpack for the higher elevations, just in case that wind kicks up or it starts snowing, you have this warm, warm layer. Now, there's nothing worse than getting caught in the rain unprepared. So I always bring my rain shell. This has a Gore-Tex material along with rain gear. You don't want your bottoms to be all wet, so you definitely want a good pair of rain pants. Most importantly, it's great to have the zipper that comes all the way up the side of your leg so that you're not trying to take your boots off and your socks off to get your pants on when you're caught in a downpour. Now, most people think that the rain gear is all you need, but even though I am a rough and tough guide, my favorite piece of equipment when it rains is my umbrella. One of the first things that gets cold when I'm hiking are my hands. So let's keep those things covered and nice and warm. Let's start with these guys. These are my really lightweight mittens. They are great with hiking poles, and they also have a little bit of grip so that you can hold on to things without them slipping. When it starts to get a lot colder, I also bring a pair of Gore-Tex, which is a waterproof material, thicker glove. Now these are really nice because there is some insulation included in that. There is a strap here so that you can tighten that and then it'll fit under your sleeve cuff. Again, these are really, really nice to have when the temperatures drop and you are out hiking. And these are my overmitts. Now these puppies are super, super warm. They have a little bit of down in them. They're really easy to get on and you can talk like a little puppet. You may be wondering what the heck is a buff, but this little material can be used as a neck gaiter, it could be used as a headband, it could be used as a sweatband, it could be used as a hat, all kinds of great things, and it's a tiny little piece of material. Now Tusker gives you one of our Tusker branded beautiful yellow buffs. You can also find buffs all over Nepal for a dollar or two, getting one for every outfit and looking really styly on the trail. Now hiking boots. Hiking boots are one of the most important things that you'll bring. You need to make sure that they fit you well so that you don't get blisters. You don't necessarily need to get a heavy duty backpacking boot, something that's leather and weighs 10 pounds. Nowadays they make great lightweight Gore-Tex boots that have a great Vibram sole, and sometimes you have to customize them yourself. Now this trip, I had an ankle bruise and had to cut this whole part out so that it was comfortable. Sometimes you just gotta do what you gotta do on the trail. These gaiters are not from Florida. They are used to keep the mud, the scree, the snow out of your boots. They go around your boot like this and then come up right below the calf and tighten here. They're also great because they keep you a little bit warmer. So if you're cold, you put these on and you have leg warmers. Now these are my approach shoes. You may think you only need to use these for rock climbing, but these are great on the trail. Now they're a low cut boot. It's something that's a little bit lighter than your actual hiking boot, but it still has a really great sticky sole. Now these are a little piece of heaven. When you get off that trail at the end of the day, all you want to do is put on some warm, cozy, fuzzy, wuzzy boots. These are it. Don't forget something that's slip-on so it's easy to get on and off when you need to use the restroom or get out of your tent. And they keep your little toesies super warm. They make me really happy. Last but not least are the flip-flops. Now, when you get off the trail, sometimes all your feet want is to breathe. So having these babies are great for just that reason. Also, when you get to shower, you do get to shower every once in a while on this trek. They definitely are needed in those bathrooms. Sun protection. This is key. When you're up at the higher altitudes, that sun is strong. So, one, you definitely want your shade hat, something that's going to cover your face and keep that sun off of your nose. Next, you definitely want a great pair of sunglasses, something that's going to wrap around and keep a lot of that UV rays out of those eyes of yours. You only get one pair, so you got to keep those things in tip-top shape. Then you want sunscreen. Every day, I'm going to be harping on all my clients, sunscreen, sunscreen, sunscreen. Reapply. Reapply every hour if you need to. Clothing doesn't have to be so serious. You can buy one of these amazing yak hats at Namche Bazaar. Trekking poles are your best friend. They will alleviate some of the weight off of your knees when you're going downhill and also keep you steady when you are walking on some of those rocks. Now, your sleeping bag. You want something that's going to be nice and warm, at least a 0-degree bag to keep you toasty warm so you can sleep at night. Now, most of the time, these things can take up the entire desk here, but you want to buy a compression sack. With this, you can stuff it in there, tighten it all the way down, and then this huge sleeping bag becomes the size of a big football. Water is your other best friend. We provide treated water for you while at camp, but in the case you need water along the trail, having one of these comes in handy. This is a water bottle with a filtration device inside that cleans out all the bad stuff so that you can drink healthy, clean water. Now, here's what you'll keep your water in. It is a hydration bladder. This is great because you fill this up in the morning. You can put 2 to 3 liters in here, and it goes into your backpack. This hose comes around and attaches right to your backpack, and you can sip water throughout the day. Now, all your stuff has to go in something. You definitely need your backpack. I like to use a 36 liter backpack. It gives me plenty of room to keep all of my extra layers, my rain gear, my hiking poles, my water, sunscreen, snacks, all that good stuff all in one place. It also has a pack cover to keep that bag nice and dry when it starts to rain. When you sign up for a Tusker trip, we'll provide you with a long, detailed gear list so that you know exactly what you need to bring so that you're prepared for all weather types. If you have any questions about your trip, you can always call the office and talk to one of our guides, and they'll be able to help you out.